What is up guys, it's Tom here and welcome back to the Liverpool transfer news update video. And in this video we will talk about Liverpool actively searching for new players, big players to bring in by Jurgen Klopp. You know, it was reported by Paul Joyce, one of the most respected journalists in terms of the Liverpool transfer news. He's reporting in the Times and Liverpool are actively searching for a midfielder that isn't Naby Keita. Let me know what do you make of this news, and also I will report on the Virgil van Dijk transfer situation, because it could still happen, because Southampton made some very interesting comments today about basically Mauricio Pellegrino needs to sell before he can buy players, and he needs to bring in funds if he wants to strengthen the team, which means that he will probably most likely sell Van Dijk, who is still on strike. He still hasn't trained with the Southampton squad for the last like 4 or 5 weeks. And I honestly think that Liverpool at this point, we are desperate to improve our defense and we should put in a bid. If we put in a 70 or 75 million pounds, Southampton will definitely think about it. They have been just bought by Gao, a Chinese businessman, and he had to take out loans just to buy the club, so he doesn't have any funds to put into the transfer budget for Southampton. So that's why the Chinese new owner Gao said to the manager Pellegrino that he has to sell players if he wants to generate funds and strengthen the team in the transfer window, and Van Dijk is unhappy anyway. So let me know what do you think about this news, what do you make of this in the comments below. And it looks like that Liverpool have finally accepted that RB Leipzig will not sell Naby Keita. Again, I still think that a club record bid would persuade them to sell, but maybe Liverpool don't have like 150 million pounds laying on the ground or in their pockets, because the Keita and Van Dijk could cost a combined 150 million pounds. And I really, really think that Liverpool should go all out for these two players. Or if Naby Keita is not available, then we should definitely go out for another player. Yesterday I said that we should go for Draxler or Seri, but it's very interesting what Paul Joyce says in the Times, that Liverpool and Jurgen Klopp also said himself that we are looking for players to strengthen the team, because even though Jurgen Klopp seems to be happy with his current options, Joyce claims that Jurgen Klopp would ideally want to supplement the current squad with another midfielder before the window closes. And frankly, if we don't sign anyone before the transfer window closes, the fans will be very, very angry and upset, me included. I expected so, so much better from Liverpool, from the transfer window, from new sporting director Michael Edwards. Remember when the older Liverpool-based journalists were saying before the transfer window even began that Liverpool will break their transfer record multiple times. We will have 200 million or 150 million to spend. And even though we brought in 3 good players, that's nowhere near good enough. We weren't even, champions last season. So it's not like we were already an awesome, awesome team that doesn't need strengthening. And look at Paris Saint-Germain. They have quite a lot of very, very good players who are surplus to requirements there. Not only Draxler is available from Paris Saint-Germain, but Krychowiak, who also used to be linked with Liverpool when he was playing for Sevilla, is a very, very good defensive midfielder. Don't tell me that Krychowiak wouldn't improve this Liverpool midfield. I'm 100% certain that he would. He's of course not as good as Naby Keita, but for a season or two, he could do a great job in the Liverpool midfield. He could add another option and he could definitely improve. And we haven't replaced Lucas Leiva, who even though wasn't a regular, he was a really good squad player that sometimes we relied on him last season. So we need to sign Krychowiak, in my opinion. Lucas Moura, another very, very exciting winger, even though, you know, some fans are saying that his end product is lacking. Don't tell me that he wouldn't be a good option for Liverpool. And in my opinion, they are not like outrageously expensive. I think Krychowiak would be available for something like 25 or 30 million pounds. And when you consider that Matic went to Man United for 40 million and he's a defensive midfielder as well, Krychowiak for 30 million would be a good buy, in my opinion. Lucas Moura for another 30 million would be a good buy as well. What will happen if Mane or Salah gets injured? We will be short again. And when the the Champions League starts in September, hopefully we will make it through to the group stage unless a major disaster happens. We need options. We cannot play Salah and Mane week in, week out, because they will get tired, they will get fatigued, they will get injured eventually, and we just cannot rely on them for the whole season. We need another backup player up front or out wide in midfield, and definitely please in the center back spot. Come on, Jurgen Klopp, come on Liverpool, I'm getting so frustrated. Let me know if you share my frustration in the comments below. I would love to hear your opinion. Jan Mobi, who used to be a brilliant player for Liverpool, he said Jurgen Klopp has spoken a fair bit in the last week about looking to strengthen the squad, and I think Liverpool will. However, I'm not sure the incomings will be top shelf. And even if we don't sign world-class players, I would be fine with just a Krihoriak, for example. Even he would improve this Liverpool squad, because the football nowadays is a squad game. There is no point having one of the best starting 11s in the league when your squad is not good enough. When on the bench you have Grujic, Ejaria, Woodburn, no disrespect to them, but look at the other team's bench. Look at Manchester United, Man City, Chelsea, Arsenal, Tottenham. Look at their bench in any Premier League game. It's a lot stronger than Liverpool. Honestly, in terms of the squad quality, at the moment Liverpool looks like the sixth best team in the Premier League. And that hurts me. That really hurts to say, but that's the brutally honest truth, in my opinion, that Liverpool on paper should finish sixth in the Premier League. And I expect so much better from this club. I expect Liverpool, season in, season out, to at least be in the conversation for the title. Maybe not win it every season, but be in the title race once in a while, every two or three seasons. That's what Liverpool should be striving for. That's what Jurgen Klopp and the Liverpool owners should be striving for. And frankly, if the owners don't have the ambition or don't have the money to take Liverpool there, they should sell the club and bring in another owner who is ambitious enough to fulfill the potential that is in this club. Because Liverpool, it looks like sometimes the fan base forgets who we are exactly. We are one of the biggest clubs in the world. We should be on the level of Manchester United, Real Madrid, Barcelona, Bayern Munich in terms of history, fan base, but you have to earn the right to be there. It's not a given. You have to earn the right to be in the Champions League. You have to earn the right to challenge for the Premier League title. You have to earn the right to get to the quarterfinals, the semifinals, or the final of the Champions League. Having a big name as the club name is no good if you don't back it up with transfers and squad depth. And we have a world-class manager, but the squad is not world-class yet. So Paul Joyce, Jan Bobby is also saying, with Virgil van Dijk, everybody now knows Southampton would rather sell to Chelsea, Arsenal or Man City than Liverpool. So I'm not convinced that will happen. I agree with him, to be honest. Southampton situation is strange. I don't know what we have done to upset Southampton to the fact they are being so stubborn about it. Southampton are a selling club, and it's not just Liverpool they sell to. They sell to everybody. They let their managers go to everybody. I still think we will sign a few decent players before the transfer window shuts, but I would like to see Van Dijk though. I really would. So those are the words of Jan Mulderby. I think we upset Southampton with how we treated the Van Dijk situation. We haven't even made the bid, and there were multiple stories in newspapers that Van Dijk wants to come to Liverpool, that Jurgen Klopp met with Van Dijk, and Southampton frankly just had enough, and they threatened to report us in the Premier League. If we did a really good bid, like £50 million, I don't think Southampton would have complained much. But let me know, feel free to disagree with me. And as I already said previously in this video, Southampton may reportedly be forced to sell Liverpool target Virgil van Dijk in order to raise funds during the final weeks of the transfer window. Because, as I already said, the Chinese owners said that they cannot give any additional transfer funds in this month to Southampton manager Pellegrino.
So the only way that the manager can strengthen the Southampton team is if he generates funds. And I even though he doesn't really want to sell Van Dijk, does he really think it's a good idea to keep an unsettled player? Because Van Dijk definitely doesn't want to play there anymore, even though he still has 5 years left on his contract. You could argue the morality of the story. Is Van Dijk right to do this? But frankly, players have all the power now. That contracts sometimes aren't even worth the paper they are written on, because if a player wants to go, most likely or not, he will get his way sooner or later. And even though Van Dijk, you know, you could argue it's not the classiest thing to go on strike, he wants to grasp this opportunity. He thinks that he could play for Liverpool and challenge for the Premier League title, challenge for the Champions League, or at least be in the conversation in the last eight or last four of these competitions. And let me know, guys, do you think that with Van Dijk in the team, Liverpool could challenge for the title? I honestly think that he makes such a massive improvement. Maybe not challenge for the title, but Liverpool would definitely finish in the top four and even challenge third or second place in the Premier League. I still think that in order for Liverpool to challenge for the title, we still need a Naby Keita and another winger to be a backup to Mane and Salah, and maybe a more prolific striker. What I also don't understand is why isn't Liverpool going all out to sign Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang, who frankly stated that he wants to leave Dortmund, and he even said on his Snapchat that he would love to play for AC Milan, but they are a sleeping giant, they are not trying to get him. And I honestly think that if Liverpool would put a serious offer on the table for Dortmund, something like 70-80 million pounds, they would sell. Because they said that they would sell at the beginning of the transfer window if somebody met their asking price. Would Aubameyang improve Liverpool? Definitely. If Aubameyang considers AC Milan, who is not even in the Champions League, to be one of his favorite destinations, he would definitely consider Liverpool and his old boss Jurgen Klopp. But these are just my thoughts and ramblings on the transfer situation. Let me know what you think about this in the comments below. And thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed this. See you later, guys. Goodbye.